how to migrate to another QNAP NAS. We all know that our data, such as our photos, videos, and files, grow pretty fast these days.
You probably have experienced notification and alert on your smartphones or laptops saying that your capacity is almost filled up.
In this case, our NAS may also experience similar situations where our drives are approaching to its maximum capacity. In this video, we will go over how to migrate your data from your existing NAS to another NAS. Whether it's a new NAS or a larger unit, this video will clearly demonstrate how to do it step by step. We've divided this video into two parts, as this one you're watching will only show you the migration process, while the second part will show you how to expand the storage pool when you're trying to expand the capacity on the larger NAS. So in this case, when your NAS is a 2-bay, which is pretty easy to fill up, we will want to migrate to a larger unit such as a 4-bay, 6-bay, or 8-bay NAS. But keep in mind that in most cases, when a user uses a 2-bay NAS, it's most likely that it will set up as a RAID 1 configuration, which is mirroring of the drives, essentially leaving only one drive's capacity. When we migrate to a larger unit, it will free up some hard drive slots, which allows you to put in new drives that expands the overall capacity. Be sure to check this link to see whether your system is capable of doing a system migration. Note that if your source NAS volume was encrypted, it can't migrate to a NAS that does not support file system encryption. Another thing to keep in mind is that if you like to keep your original MyQNAP cloud ID of the source NAS, it does not transfer automatically. Therefore, you would need to change the source NAS ID to something else first so that the new NAS can take over the same ID. So let's get started with our migration process. First, turn off the source NAS and unplug the hard drives. Second, remove the hard drives from the old trays and install them to the hard drive trays of the new NAS. Number three, plug the hard drives to the destination NAS, which is your new model or your larger unit. Make sure that the hard drives are installed in the original order. Turn on the new NAS, and you can log into your web administration interface, your QTS, with a default login ID and password, which is both admin. If you're prompted to update the firmware of the new NAS, follow the instructions to download and install the firmware. After the original files that have been successfully migrated, you can now start plugging in the new drives that you purchased to expand the total capacity of the NAS. Thanks for watching, and please make sure to check out our other videos.